Hello, Rumwango. Good morning, everyone. How are you? I hope you all are fine. Now, let's start with the verbs. This is chapter 15 in your book. Verbs. Verbs are all about action words. Action words. Fine. So, whatever action is going on in the sentence, you have to think it as a verb. All right. Meena goes to school every day. So, Meena is a noun. School is a noun. Goes is a verb. Action. What action tells you? See. First of all, raise your hands. Come on, everyone, raise your hands. Yes. So this, shake them. Right. Clap. Very good. So this is all, whatever you have done right now, this is all action verbs. Right. So this is called verb. Now look at this sentence. Birds fly in the sky. So what birds are doing? Flying. Birds is a noun and fly is a verb. Okay, so all doing words are called verbs. The word which tells us, speak with me everyone, the word which tells us what a person, animal or thing does is known as a doing word or verb. You have to learn this definition by heart. But in short, you should always remember that all doing words, action words are verb. Understand? Now let's start with the exercise. Underline the verbs in these sentences. Eat your breakfast quickly. What action is going on? Breakfast is a noun. See, something is present in front of you. It's not moving, right? So eat. Eat is an action. Now my sister sings well. What your sister is doing? Sings, right? The dog barks at night. What dog is doing? Barks. So bark is a verb. Children play in the park. What children are doing? Play. Play is action. I swim in the evening. Swim. Underline swim, everyone. Meena draws pictures. Underline draws. Father drives a car. So drives is the action. Grandma walks in the morning. Walks is the action. Fatima often helps me in the kitchen. Helps is the action. The lion roars when it is angry. Roars is an action. So this is something which you already know from the class second also. There is something more. What? Am is are. Yes, am is are. They are also verbs. Yes. This is something new, isn't it? So whenever you find these three words in the sentence, you should consider them as verbs. Let's read these sentences. I am a dancer. The dog is very active. The chairs are new. So see, am, is, are. What are these? Very good. Verbs. Right. On the page now. Am, is, are, has, have, and had, was, were. They all are verbs. They all are verbs. Speak with me. Is, am, are, has, have, was, were, had. They all are verbs, right? So now here, you have to underline the given verbs. Monica is a good girl. What verb is here? Is. Similarly, are. Here, the dress is gorgeous. Is. The baby is hungry. Is. Sachin is a good batsman. Is. The trees in the garden are tall. Are. I am a student of class 3. See the verb am. Elephants are large animals. Are. Deer are timid animals. Are. Beena is my classmate. Is. I already told you. Has and have are verbs. I'll tell you later on that where to use has and where to use have, because this is the next chapter. So then I will tell you. But right now, just consider on the verb only. Consider the verb. Tanu has long hair. Has. The doll has blue eyes. See, doll is a noun. Has. And blue is the adjective there. The children have new toys. Children is noun. Toys is noun, new is adjective. So what is this? This is verb. Monali has a new dress. Monali is noun. Dress is a noun. New is adjective. Has is verb. Vani and Manu have a new friend. The room has many windows. Underline this have and has. The book has interesting stories. Underline has. The spider has 8 legs. Underline has. We have a holiday tomorrow. Underline have. He has a little sister. Underline has. Similarly, now come to the D part in your book. Underline the verbs in the following sentence. Now see, it's not mandatory that only you will find this has, have, is, mr and nothing else. No other verb is present. No. There are exceptions. See this. Now the stars are shining in the sky. So if you notice that there are two verbs. See. First one you say ki are. Okay, this is verb. Shining, verb. So beta, whenever you find is, mr, was, were, has, have with other verb, then we will consider this as a helping verb, because this is the main verb. Shining is a main verb. R is helping it. Indeed, R is that a verb. Okay, fine. But whenever is, mr, was, were, has, have, had comes with along with the another verb, then we consider them as helping verb. Okay. See, in these sentences, they were all being verb because they were the only verbs, right? But in this one, they will be considered as helping verb. So I'm writing on top helping verb, and this is the main verb. We are doing our homework. So this is the main verb, doing, main verb, and are helping verb. Are reading. So reading is a main verb. Are is helping verb. Similarly, underline, my grandmother is walking in the garden. So is helping, helping verb, and walking is main verb. I am feeling hungry. No, see this. Feeling is verb, the main verb. Am again is helping verb. Understand? The baby is crying. So again, this is verb, this is helping verb. Similarly, in 7, the telephone is ringing. So, is ringing, underline. The plane will be arriving soon, underline. They have called, underline. Tina has found her pet dog, underline the has found. I have a new pencil box, underline have. The soldiers are marching down the road, underline are marching. Got it?